The Milwaukee police chief apologizing for the handling of Bucks guard Sterling Brown's arrest. Brown was tased and handcuffed during a January arrest for a parking violation. Stephen A., what's your reaction to this? To the arrest
itself? I'm not
satisfied.
Yeah. I am not satisfied. That is my immediate reaction. The reason why I'm not satisfied is because the apology on a part of the Milwaukee police does not mean a damn thing to me at this particular moment in time, and here is why. I want names. Who are the officers who did this? What are their names? A. B. What specifically is the punishment? What do you mean they've been disciplined? How do we know that the disciplinary actions were satisfactory? I mean, it seems to be incredibly vague. The fact of the matter is that if this particular athlete had done something wrong, we would certainly know who he is. So why don't we know who the officers are that transgressed, and why don't we know what specifically the punishment is? Have they been suspended without pay? Do they still have their jobs? Has their pension been compromised? Have they been resigned to desk duty? Have they received a pay cut? Are they denied any promotions, et cetera, et cetera? I want names, and I want to know what the punishment is, okay? That's number one. Number two, I want to applaud Sterling Brown because here's where it gets really, really special for me. The fact is that he conducted himself the way on many, many occasions I've advocated many individuals within my very own community conduct themselves. He was very non-threatening. He didn't do anything wrong. There was nothing that he did that warranted what the officers did. He seemed to be cognizant of the fact that I better sit up here and mind my manners. Let me not allow my emotions to get the best of me, because this police officer, which ultimately turned into several police officers, seemed to be looking for an excuse to take me down, literally, figuratively, and otherwise. And while Black Americans throughout this country have every right to be emotional, have every right to be disgusted with the state of affairs that exists on the part of some police officers, not all police officers, on the part of just some, the reality is clear. You got to live another day. Be wise and be smart enough and recognize the fact that these are law enforcement officials that you're dealing with. And in the moment of conflict, the power lies with them. So it's incumbent upon you to keep your cool. Don't react emotionally, and don't give them any reason with your movements, your temperament, or beyond to come at you with physical harm. Don't do it. Be mindful of it and guard against it. As wrong as they may be, the objective is not to be right. The objective is to survive first and then worry about being right later. I think Sterling Brown got that. I think his behavior exemplified that, which obviously really diminishes whatever level of justification the law enforcement officials may have had in doing what they did. I want names. I want to know who they are. And I want to know specifically what the punishment is. That apology doesn't mean a damn thing to me, because you're not telling me anything other than here's an apology, we're sorry, and then you could have just gone back doing what you've been doing. I want to know who the officers are immediately, right here on First Take on national television. I am calling for those officers' name, their titles, and I want to know exactly what the discipline is. Then maybe we will be satisfied.